Moving on to Zambia. Father, this is a very interesting story. But a few weeks ago, some Zambian activists asked the US ambassador to Zambia to prevent the Zambian First Lady from going to America to receive the donation of 4 fire trucks. So a US-based organization known as the Los Angeles Lusaka Sister Committee decided to give 4 fire trucks to Zambia. This organization worked with the LA Fire Department and the LA County Fire Department, who actually donated this fire trucks, and they donated it to the country of Zambia via the First Lady's Foundation. Now, the problem is the First Lady decided to go to America to receive the fire trucks with a 25-people delegation. And Zambians were like, why do we need to fly 25 people to America to receive 4 fire trucks? Keep in mind that among the delegates were bedroom attendants, cooks, cleaners, waiters. I don't even understand. I don't know why she needs a bedroom attendant or cook or cleaner or waiter when she would be staying in a hotel in America. And this is in addition to 7 police officers that would go with her, 4 journalists. Why do you need four different journalists to cover one event? Just because you are receiving a donation. And that is in addition to 3 secretaries, as well as 2 fire brigade officers, which is funny because I was actually thinking there would be more firefighters in this equation. Anyway, and then they had 1 communications officer and an accountant, all because they want to go and collect fire trucks in America. On top of that, they said that they would spend 2 weeks in America receiving fire trucks. 2 weeks, haba, eberolo, even in Zambia. Oh yeah, come on, eberolo, we should always fear God. Of course, Zambians were outraged, at least some of them, only for the government to say that the delegates were going with the First Lady in order to go and assess if the fire trucks are in conformity with Zambian standard. I was like, really? The cook is going to assess the fire truck? I mean, we like to deceive ourselves. What's so funny is when I read the article, the government official kept saying this is a VVVIP trip. VVVIP. Anyway, I can understand Zambians being upset though, because when I checked the price of flight from Lusaka in Zambia to LA, it's like $1,600 per person. Now, maybe they got their own ticket cheaper, I don't know, but this was economy. And I know that the First Lady would not sit in the economy. So if they paid $1,600 for 25 people to go to America, that would be $40,000 on flight alone. Economy, again, they may find cheaper tickets, I don't know, but I also found tickets for like $2,000 and more. But this calculation that I made is based on if they paid $1,600 per person. Also, a hotel can be expensive in LA, but again, let's assume they decided to stay in a $200 per night hotel, and I know that the First Lady would not stay in such a cheap hotel. There are hotels for $600, $700 per night for regular rooms. So $200 for 40 days, that would be $2,800 for 25 rooms. Since there are 25 people, that would be $70,000 for that. And of course, we know that the First Lady would stay in some kind of executive suite. In any case, $40,000 plus $70,000, that's already $110,000 for flight and accommodation alone. Once again, these are just my calculations. I may be wrong. Now, let's assume that for food, they were spending $20 per meal. Again, I'm being economical about this. 3 meals in a day would be $60 per person, and for 2 weeks, that would be $840 per person times 25 people. That is $21,000. Add that to the hotel and flight fee, we are looking at about $131,000 in the name of going to receive fire trucks in America. Do you know that they could actually buy some used fire trucks in very good condition with that amount of money? Anyway, other people in Zambia were saying that she should have diverted that money into education, and that would change the lives of so many students, which I agree with. Now, when people started complaining in Zambia, the government said that the organization giving the fire trucks would also take care of some of the travel expenses, although they didn't tell us how much. But even if they did, why waste so much money? In any case, despite the outcry, the First Lady went to America, and she spent 2 weeks receiving ambulance, and they did the ceremony. This is a picture from the event. It wasn't supposed to be like a serene ceremony. It was just supposed to be, we give this to you, 5 people maximum. They will still get their fire trucks. Then I was curious that the fire trucks must be new if they will spend that much money to go and collect these fire trucks. But from the look of the pictures, especially the small one in that picture, it doesn't look new to me. Only for me to find a news coverage of the event where they described the fire trucks.
Fire Chief Daryl Ospie will be handing the keys of 4 recently retired fire engines seen down below here to representatives of the Republic of Zambia. Not one, but 2 fire departments are saying goodbye to fire engines and equipment that have faithfully served the Los Angeles area for decades.
What? I'm so sorry. trucks that they've been using for decades. Just like, I'm sorry, but that's just ridiculous. You spend all that money to go and collect trucks that they've been using for decades? Seriously? And then I saw one of the videos from the event where they specifically said that one of the fire trucks was from 1996. I was like, what?
The apparatus that we're donating is to my left, a 1996 Seagrave. That just came out of service in Hollywood just a few months ago. It not only has been tuned up, we have hose, we have nozzles, we have fittings, we have ladders, we have rotary saws. That can hit the streets tomorrow and do its job.
So they say goodbye to these engines, but they are so happy to give them to the Republic of Zambia.
There's nothing wrong in collecting trucks that they've been using for decades, so long as they are in good condition. In fact, we will take them in Nigeria. But they could have minimized the expense of going to collect the fire trucks. By this time, I was really curious and I wanted to know what year were the other fire trucks. So I called the LA Fire Department and also the LA County Fire Department, and they were so nice to me. They told me that two of the fire trucks are from 1985, one is from 1995, and the last one is from 1996. So but they are in good condition. It's not like they are no longer in good condition. They are still in good condition. And to be honest with you, if the firemen were to sell those trucks, they can make a lot of money by selling those trucks here in the US. They still go for a huge amount of money. So it's a wonderful thing that they decided to give it to Zambia. My only issue is how much money the government of Zambia spent in the name of coming to collect these fire trucks. I personally found some really good fire trucks online for much cheaper. Look at this one, for example, a 2002 fire truck for $43,000, 2002. In fact, I found another one for $60,000. Let's say they want a newer one. At the same time, I found a 2002 for $28,000. They would have bought four of that. This one is $35,000. At least they will buy three of that and save some money.